Satellite promises improved forecasting. Fairbanks, a satellite scheduled to launch early this morning, promises to improve forecasts of hazardous incidents in Alaska, such as better predicting spring breakup flooding and volcanic ash movement. The new satellite also is designed to collect data that will make global weather forecasts more accurate. The $1.6 billion satellite is named JPSS-1 because it's the first of four orbiters in the planned Joint Polar Satellite System, which will launch during the next 15 years. The new satellite are an update to the United States' aging constellation of polar weather satellites. Polar satellites like JPSS are especially important here because they pass over Alaska as they circle around the poles. Geostationary satellites, which orbit around the equator, don't have as good an angle to see the 49th state, especially the region north of the Brooks Range. The polar satellites also fly at a much lower altitude compared to the geostationary satellites, making it easier to capture high-quality imagery. As of Monday night, the rocket carrying JPSS-1 was scheduled to launch at 12:47 a.m. AXT today from Vandenberg Air Force Base in California. Once it's in orbit and operating, the new satellite will be known as NOAA-20, the 20th satellite since 1970, named for its mission for the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. JPSS-1 carries a similar suite of instruments as Suomi NPP, a 2011 test satellite that's still operational, although nearing the end of its expected lifespan. Suomi NPP was designed to bridge the gap between older satellites and the JPSS. The instruments include advanced cameras and tools that calculate heat and moisture at different altitudes. Between the Suomi NPP and JPSS-1, a next-generation satellite will capture high-quality images across Alaska 8 times every day, said JPSS program scientist Mitch Goldberg at a telephone news conference last week. At a news conference, Anchorage meteorologist Nate Eckstein discussed applications of the satellites such as predicting the breakup flooding that occurs when chunks of ice block melting rivers in the spring, redirecting rivers out of their banks and sometimes flooding into towns. Meteorologists previously relied on reports from airplane pilots to monitor breakup. Satellites and drones are both making it easier, Eckstein said. Before this product, we didn't have anything that told us the percentage of ice and the percentage of open water in a river area, he said. That kind of information is really key to know up and down the entire river system. The new satellite may also save fuel for large jetliners that fly the Great Circle route over the top of the North Pole. When volcanoes along the Aleutian Islands emit ash, meteorologists give pilots conservative estimates for what areas to avoid. More than 80,000 large aircraft per year fly these routes. 30,000 people per day are potentially downwind of an Aleutian volcanoes, Eckstein said. This allows us to produce a forecast more quickly, gives us a greater degree of confidence and allow us to shrink the warning area. Beyond Alaska, polar satellites collecting key data are important globally for long-term weather forecasts. It's hard to quantify exactly how much the new satellite will improve forecasts, but Goldberg said that satellites in polar orbits in general provide 85% of the data used for forecast models. There has been a tremendous improvement in the 3 to 7 day forecast in the last 10 years, and that improvement is a combination of advanced observation, mostly from microwave and infrared sounders, instruments found on JPSS, as well as the modeling, as well as the computer power, he said. Polar orbiting satellites are the backbone with respect to observations going into the model. I can't overstate the importance of that data for the forecast model. Thanks for watching. Please like, comment and subscribe to see new videos every day in my channel, World News Today.